Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this CorelDRAW Basics for Beginners video, we'll be using some basic shapes, like we have this modified ellipse here, and some basic fountain fills to create this balloon graphic. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. You can support my channel through Patreon. Also, don't forget to subscribe. I put up lots of videos every single week. Here's my current list that I'm putting up, plus I'm putting up some CorelDRAW videos mixed in there as well. And take a look at my CorelDRAW training course. You'll find a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. We're now going to make this balloon. I'm just going to delete this file. There we go. I won't even bother saving that one. And we'll start with a brand new document right here, or of course a little button right there. Either one's fine. I have this set at the default sizes and add a portrait size right there, portrait dimension. Choose OK. Here we go. The first thing we need is to grab the ellipse tool over here, left-hand side, and just draw an ellipse kind of in the shape you want of the balloon. Something kind of like that. And then go up here to the pick tool. We can move this around a little bit. Now use the wheel on the mouse to zoom in just a bit. We don't want that more distinctive balloon shape, which is skinnier at the bottom and rounder on the top. So right click and choose Convert to Curves. Now move over here to the Shape tool. And notice we have these little nodes on the bottom, two sides, and the top. Click on the bottom node and then grabbing this control hand, either here or here, doesn't matter which one you grab, pull it in towards the center. That's how they both move together. And that squeezes the bottom in. We can now pull this down like that and give us the shape for the bottom of the balloon. I want to have more of a round shape up here, so I'll grab the top node and pull this down a little bit to create more of that top shape. Looks pretty good. You can, of course, fine-tune this until you adjust the shape that you want. So there's our basic balloon shape. Let's go back to the pick tool and click on cyan. That fills us with cyan. And then right-click on the square with the X up here. That sets the stroke to no color. So if you right-click a color, I'll just do black here, right-click, that gives you that color for your stroke. Let's right click no color, and left click gives you the color for the balloon. So there's a red balloon and there's a cyan. So right click is fill, left click is stroke. Okay, there we go. There's the basic balloon. Let's now put a gradient into this balloon. Go over here to that little double arrow at the bottom of the tools right here and grab the interactive fill. Now this might be showing on your list of tools. It depends upon what size monitor you're working with. Click into the shape and then just pull, and this gives you your fill setup. Now what you want to do is you want to go to the bottom one, double click on that so you get the color pop up here, set this to the swatches, and click on cyan. So we have cyan at the bottom down there, and cyan right in the middle. Now click on the top one, you get your color options here, and to the right of that we have the transparency. Let's now slide this over so it says about 76 in here, and that gives you a transparency in the middle. Now at this point I have it transparent here and kind of fading out. You can see there. We can change the kind of transparency shape up here using the options. I'll click on this one. This will give us an elliptical transparency. Let's just pull this up back to the center again, and I'll change these around. I'll set the bottom one to 0. There we go. And this one that's in the middle, set this back up to 76. There we go. And that gives us that kind of nice soft coloration in there. Just like that. And back to our pick tool. So there's the basic balloon look. Let's now put in our two reflections. We'll start off with another ellipse, and I'll put it right here at the top. Make it about that big and about that shape. Back to the pick tool. We can now click it once and rotate the shape around a little bit. You can then reposition it. At this point, you can resize if you want to. That's kind of where we want to have the top shape in here. Let's now fill this with white. So left click white and then right click on no color. So I have just that coloration. Now we can put a gradient on this. Come down here, the transparency tool, and set the transparency at a fountain transparency. So this has zero transparency up to 100% transparency. So we'll leave it at the defaults, which is 100% up here, or actually 0% transparency here, 100% down there. So we have the transparency along the bottom and its full value at the top. Now, let's convert this to curves. So click on the shape, right click, and convert to curves. Move back over here to the shape tool, grab the bottom node, and just push that in like that. And that gives us that kind of a kind of bent shape right here. Let's do the same thing down below, but we'll do a much longer, thinner one. So a long, thin ellipse, kind of like that. Back to the pick tool. You can click it a second time, and you can then rotate that. So rotate it about like that, so it's kind of along that edge. Do the same thing with our fill. Left click white, right click no color. Let's put our transparency on this one as well. Click on the transparency and click on the gradient transparency, fountain transparency. I want to reverse these two values. So at the click on the bottom one and set that to 0. Click on the top one and set that to 100. Just reverses that. There we go. We now need to get this to fit our shape a bit better. So I'm going to right click on this, convert to curves, back to the shape tool. This time grab the corners or these points. Just kind of pull the points in, just kind of bends that around like that. Back to the pick tool, get this back into position. And let's double check our transparency. Click on transparency, and we need to move those a little bit here. Just kind of move their positions. And then set the one at this bottom edge that says 0 right now, set that to 50. You can just type that in if you want to. So you have a subtle highlight here and a brighter highlight there. Okay, let's now put a little thing at the bottom. Back again to the ellipse tool. And we'll do just a small ellipse right down here like that. Same thing on our colors. Left click cyan, right click on no color. Let's push that up against the balloon. You can also use your arrow keys to move this around a little bit. Now I'm going to use the wheel on the mouse to zoom in just a bit, just like that. Let's give this a gradient. This time I want to have an actual gradient and not a transparency. So I'll come down to this little double arrow, gradient, and click and pull. See, here's our gradient. Let's just spin this around so it's white at the top like that and full transparency at the bottom, or even up a little bit, that's fine. You can take this slider control here and actually adjust how the transparency is behaving. Just push up towards the top a little bit. On the top one, let's set this value down just a bit. So we get a little bit, maybe about 25. Get a little bit of a see-through effect on that, just a touch. Now right-click and convert to curves. Back to the shape tool, click on that bottom and just push that up like that. It'll snap to the center position, and that's about right. And then let's just use the arrow keys to kind of fine-tune that. There we are. and then wheel mouse and back out a little bit so you can see the whole balloon. But there you go, that's how you do your basic balloon shape. And again, we used, as you can see here, several different tools to achieve this.